Look at the new definitions of key workers. You know, it's very different to what we would have thought about 2 years ago. You know, key workers are, for instance, our bin men who are doing a fabulous job, certainly where I live in Kensington and Chelsea. So I do think that this crisis is going to make us think very, very differently, like coming out of the world wars. You know, we did go through a reassessment as to how we wanted to look as a society. And I completely agree with David that we need to be at the forefront of that. I would also like to say to David that I'm very conscious that businesses are going through a very uncertain time at the moment. If you look at stock market valuations, property valuations, so that's what makes his commitment and his donation even more powerful.
And Victoria, what difference do you think it would make to charitable foundations and community groups across the country if we did something radical like added a percentage point to corporation tax for charities, as David has just signed up to do?
I think what's interesting about that is the issue of financial security. So particularly for the smaller local partners that we work with, they're hand to mouth every year. Every year you start with nothing, you write your fundraising plan, and you try and bring that money in for your work, and there's no financial security whatsoever. If something like this.
What does that mean? So explain in very simple terms what that means for you, running.
So in our case, for example, we're not one of those organisations that has a huge endowment that just sits there and earns us money, and we decide how to spend that and deploy that. We have to raise everything that we want to spend. And we plan that out really carefully based on what's worked in previous years, what's most cost effective. But a crisis like this makes a lot of that activity that you were budgeting for impossible to deliver. Now we're really lucky that we have some big funders, private funders, who fund our core costs, so we haven't had to furlough any of our staff.
So people like Cadogan are one of those backers, aren't they?
Exactly, Cadogan and Rousing Trust, and Martin's Properties, and City Bridge Trust. But most charities we're talking to have had to furlough staff, and a lot of those staff are fundraisers. So there's going to be a huge hole in those budgets later on. And simultaneously, we're hearing that post-lockdown, a lot of the charities are expecting a huge spike in need for their services. So there are lots of women in abusive households at the moment who cannot make calls to domestic violence helplines because their abuser is sitting right next to them on the sofa. So as soon as those guys are going back to work, there'll be a huge increase in need for those services. Similarly, I was talking yesterday to our partners that work on local gang crime issues, and they're saying that at the moment, the demand for recreational drugs has just completely dried up. So all the gangs are competing to supply a kind of small group of hardcore addicts, and they've got all this surplus product. As soon as lockdown's over, they're all going to try and shift that product really quickly, which means more competition and more violence. And at the same time as that's happening, you've got increased unemployment. So more young people are going to be tempted to join gangs and use crime, gang crime, as a way to make money. So all these issues are only just going to start scratching the surface when lockdown finishes, and we're thinking, oh, it's all over, this is great. No, it's not, it's just the beginning. So we're concerned about those charities having an increase in need at the same time as they have a deficit in funds.
And Felicity, don't worry, I'm not going to ask you to make up tax policy on the spot. We can leave that one. We can leave
I'm happy to do so,
I
but I
think
just
David's
don't
done
have the
that for
power
you.
to
Leave
implement
that one to me, Andrew.
it
Yeah.
Okay, we'll give him Rishi Sunak's rise. Felicity, you could
David's
well be
on
in
it.
number 11 by the end of the year. So let's preempt that. But look, on a more serious note, Victoria's obviously raised a number of extremely pertinent points there. I mean, obviously, the government is having to respond on a daily basis to all sorts of things at the minute. But as we start to think about the medium-term response, what ways do you think policymakers can engage with organisations like Kensington and Chelsea Foundation to try and get some kind of grip on the myriad issues that Victoria's outlined?
Well, I would say as a first thing that I think that we've got a great collaborative relationship, whether it's Kensington and Chelsea Foundation, the council, me as an MP, are amazing donors. So I think that all works very, very well. I think the most important thing actually is that as an economy, we come out of this strongly so that we have a V-shaped recovery, because it's only with a strong recovery that we actually have the tax revenue to pay for what we want to do. And also it's only with a strong recovery that we have philanthropists who are able to donate to charities. And again, only with a strong recovery will people be in jobs. So that is very important. But clearly government has got a very difficult job at the moment to finesse the intention and the desire to protect people by shielding them and their houses versus getting the economy back moving again. And that is something that we're going to have to adjust day in, day out.